If Israel stopped fighting, what would happen? If they laid down all their guns tomorrow, what would happen?
Personally, I can't say. I'm not in charge of any of the leadership.
Yes, so all the Jews would be killed. If Hamas
it's
laid down...
It's not about Judaism, though. If Israel's actually the ones that have taken Palestine's land.
Okay, again, I'm just trying to find some moral clarity. If Hamas laid down all of their weapons, what would we have?
There would be no more Palestine.
Peace is what we would have.
No, that's...
We would have peace.
Excuse my language.
Hello, welcome to my YouTube channel. Hope you are feeling good. Today, we are going to be checking out another video from Charlie Kirk. Titled Charlie Kirk Decimates Pro Hamas Student. Wow, I believe this is going to be an interesting one. So let's start with the video. Go.
I'm a proud member of the Young Democratic Socialists of America on campus. I'm expecting boos from that. I don't mind.
No, you're around conservatives, so.
Also, for the record, not that it matters, but if I were to host an event on campus, I'd be more than happy to have people disagree with me to come first. Unfortunately, I do not get to host events. I wish. First off, I want to just make a small factual correction to something that you said, which is about the 130 migrants on the terror list that have crossed the border. The actual number is 160, and those were numbers that had been stopped at the border, meaning they were prevented from entering, which means that these people were stopped during the Biden administration.
Right. So you're not exactly strengthening your argument. It's actually higher. Thank you. And so how many gotaways have there been at the border this year?
Say that again. Sorry.
Gotaways? People that weren't tracked that we don't know that came into the interior?
Unfortunately, that's kind of hard to track, as you said. However, that's actually – I just wanted to –
Yeah, it's about 500,000 minimum.
Wow. Okay.
Yeah,
I just wanted
wow.
to give you that number, though, just so that you're aware. But that's actually not my question. My point was about Palestine.
What country
Palestine.
Is that? Oh, okay, where is that?
In the Middle East.
Wait, is it in Judea and Samaria?
I'm sorry, say that again. I can't hear you.
What country are you talking about?
Palestine.
It exists?
Yes.
Oh.
In fact, it existed before the current Israel.
Oh, really?
Yes.
According to who?
According to history books.
Oh, okay. So wait, you mean Judea and Samaria, the rightful homeland of the Jews that they call the West Bank and they're currently occupying?
If you're going by religion, sure. I personally don't go by religion.
Oh, what do you go by then? What where the Arabs want to occupy?
Logic.
Oh, really?
History.
So whose is Gaza?
Gaza is a location. I'm sorry, I'm getting a call and I don't want that to interfere in the mic. Gaza's location within Palestine. But I'd like to go on to my point, if you will. Currently, Israel is actually being labeled by international human rights organizations such as Amnesty International as an apartheid state because they are attacking many people from within Palestine, and they have been actually – the land has been stolen from Palestine. Not to say that the people in Israel do not deserve their own land. I am a believer in a two-state solution. I want to make that clear. And I also want to make clear that I do not agree with the recent incidents because there is no excuse for harming civilians. However, I do want to
Good,
make –
you're morally
point.
Clear on that. Good.
Thank you. I do want to make clear that also Israel has captured more than 228 Palestinian children, in which they held in containment. And of these, 86% were beaten. Oh, and these were, by the way, the 220 is only those that were able to be surveyed, so they were recovered. The 86% of those were beaten in detention, 69% were strip searched, and 42% were injured at the point of arrest. Additionally, I would like to add, due to your claim about dictators, that Benjamin Netanyahu has been in power since 2009, and he also held in power since from 1996 to 1999.
That's
argue
true.
That
there's actually a moment when he wasn't prime minister.
That's why I said
Naftali Bennett
well
was actually, and he's duly elected. When was the last time Abbas won an election?
Say that again?
When was the last time Mahmoud Abbas won an election?
That I do currently not have.
Yeah, 8 years. They don't hold elections because they're under a dictatorship. I'm just curious because I want to try to find some clarity more than agreement because we're not going to find agreement. If Israel stopped fighting, what would happen? If they laid down all their guns tomorrow, what would happen?
I personally can't say. I'm not in charge of any of the leadership.
Yes, so all the Jews would be killed. If Hamas
it's
laid down –
It's not about Judaism, though.
If
Israel's actually the ones that have taken Palestine's land.
Okay, again, I'm just trying to find some moral clarity. If Hamas laid down all of their weapons, what would we have?
There would be no more Palestine.
Peace is what we would have.
No, that's
– We would have peace.
Excuse my language, but that's bullshit.
Okay, so let me ask this. Why did Israel give Gaza back to the Arab Muslims? For peace. Why did they give the Sinai to Egypt for peace?
Why did they throw missiles over there?
No, hold on a second. Why did they give the Sinai to Egypt for peace? Why did they give the Gaza Strip to the Palestinian Authority for peace? In Hamas's charter, what does it say?
I'm not defending Hamas.
Hold on a second. Right. You're defending the Palestinian Authority, which is partners with Hamas, and they duly elected them.
How is
Hamas's charter any different than Nazi Germany's charter towards the Jews?
I'm not defending any of that. And for one,
what are you defending exactly?
For one, I'm defending the right of Palestine to exist, which I want to clarify. I am not telling you that you're being Islamophobic by supporting Israel. I'm not telling you that you want to kill the Muslims. So trying to say that the existence of Palestine is anti-Semitic.
Here's a fact. Let me tell you. I think this last weekend displayed the holes in your argument. When Jews go for their high holy day, Arabs come in and kill Jews. When Arabs want to have peace, the Jews will come to the table for a peace agreement. Abraham Accords, the Oslo Accords. Any time that the Arabs want to talk, the Jews will come to the table to talk in the pursuit of peace. Meanwhile, this weekend, in a slight vulnerability, what happened? Jews are celebrating the end of Yom Kippur, the reading of the Torah, and they come in and they kill 900 Jews. And answer me this. If this was an isolated incident, why were they greeted as heroes by the people of Gaza after they killed 900 women and children?
I want to make this clear once more because you seem to not be understanding. I am not defending these actions. I am simply refuting the claims that you made earlier in this argument.
Here's the thing. I think a two-state solution sounds great if you don't actually live in reality. Let me tell you what reality is. The Arabs don't want to govern their own people. They would rather hate Jews. Every day they're saying death to the Jews, kill the Jews. They do not want to govern their own people. There is no middle ground when they have they're screaming to the sky for Antifada. Israel has been at the table time and time again. Do you agree? Abraham Accords, trying to find peace, trying to sit down with Mahmoud Abbas.
The Israelites have hundreds of Palestinian children in detention. They have sent missiles to Palestine and killed hundreds of civilians. After this event, Netanyahu declared that he will send missiles to Palestine in an area where the Palestinian civilians are not able to leave.
Wait, hold on a second. You mean to Gaza?
Yes.
Right, where they actually gave warnings to apartment buildings. What kind of
–
Israel is so bad
Gaza.
That they tell people
they
to leave before they bomb them. Hamas comes on a holy day in the kibbutzes and cuts women's heads off at concerts. The moral equivalence is so different. And let me just ask you, what do you think is a bigger impediment to peace, Hamas or Israel?
If you would like, I'd prefer if you could stop interrupting me.
I'm the speaker. You're not. So let me just remind you, you're a college kid. You say you came to our event. So let me just ask you a very clear question. Bigger impediment to peace, Palestinian Authority or Israel?
Israel.
Prove it.
Israel.
Tell me one situation where Israel has not come to the table. Israel has given up land. When was the last time the Palestinian Authority willingly gave up land for peace?
Israel's bombing
never,
the land.
Never, because they don't want peace. They want dead Jews. And we as Americans should never put up with the intentional extermination of Jews again in our country. Thanks for being here. Thank
Israel.
You. Thank you. We're going to the next question.
Do not argue that when you have these debates.
We're going to the next question.
It's
thank
not
you.
About race.
Thank
so
you.
Why is it about it there?
We're
going to
take the next question. Thank you.
Thank you.
That is closeted Jew hatred laundered through Arab talking points.
Wow. What an interesting debate. You can tell the student was not being honest, though he was intellectually honest to some extent, because at a point he said it's not actually supporting Israel or supporting Palestine, that he will be very happy if there's a two-state solution. So I think for that, I can say he was intellectually honest to some extent. But just by what Chalakek said, that having a two-state solution is something that will be nearly impossible, because the Hamas, which is in charge of the governance of Gaza, I belabored a terrorist group, and I don't think they'll be ready for anything like a two-state solution, because I believe, just by what Chalakek have said in this video, around 2005, the people of Israel decide to give up their land in pursuit of peace so they can make peace with the people of Gaza. And according to statistics, about 10,000 Israeli residing in Gaza in 2005. They were forced out of Gaza by the IDF soldiers. And you can imagine a lot of those Israeli have lands in Gaza, have houses in Gaza, has property in Gaza, but they were forced out of Gaza by the IDF soldier, by Israel IDF soldier, in order to be able to make peace with Palestine, in order to be able to make peace with the people of Gaza. And immediately, Israel gave up the governance of Gaza. The people of Palestine, the people of Gaza, they voted Hamas into power. And Hamas coming into power has made life miserable for the people of Gaza. And even the peace agreement that was signed between Israel and Gaza, when Hamas came into power, they break the peace agreement. They break the peace agreement, and we can tell ever since then there have been a lot of conflict. There have been a lot of bomb missile coming from Gaza to Israel, missile coming from Israel to Gaza, and because of this incident, a lot of people have lost their life. And I think the student wasn't being honest. The student wasn't being honest for the fact that Israel could give up their land, Gaza, which originally belonged to Israel, for the fact Israel could give up their land in order for them to come into a peace agreement with the people of Gaza. I believe if Hamas are to pull down their weapon, I believe the people of Israel will be willing to negotiate with them in order for them to get the peace. Because after all, they gave up their land in 2005, and they even drove their citizens residing in Gaza. But 10,000 Israeli residing in Gaza was drove out by the IDF soldier in order for them to seek for peace from the people of Gaza. So I believe if Hamas is to pull down their weapon, I believe Israel is going to be ready for negotiation. Israel will be ready for negotiation. Israel will be ready to make peace. And I can't say the same thing about Hamas. I believe if Israel is to pull down their weapon, I believe Hamas will take that as an opportunity to wipe out Israel. Because I think I watched a video in the internet. I don't know. I think I watched a video in the internet where a little kid from someone below the age of 18 was calling his mother in Palestine and telling his mother that he has killed four Israeli, he has killed 9 Israeli, and they were all shouting Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, glory be to God, Allahu Akbar, just because a child that is not even up to 18 has murdered about 9 Israeli. They were all rejoicing. They were all celebrating. So I feel if Israel is to pull down their weapon in order to be able to seek for peace, I believe Hamas will take that as an opportunity to wipe out the people of Israel. And currently, right now, everyone is blaming Israel, and everyone is blaming Israel, and they are saying Israel is trying to play victim. Israel is trying to play victim. They all forgot the incident that happened when the people of Israel were celebrating their holy day. The Hamas, which have been labeled as a terrorist group, flew over the fence of Israel, and killed more than 900 people. They raped the women, kidnapped children. I believe the main problem the people of Palestine is having. The main problem the main problem the people of Gaza is having is Hamas, which has been labeled as a terrorist group. Right now, if you go to Gaza today, you can discover that the people of Gaza, they are suffering. Because from the information I'm getting, there's no water, there's no electricity, there's no hospital. You can tell ever since Israel gave up the governance of Gaza. Gaza has become more poor ever since the time Hamas was voted into power. And you can't tell me they don't have money to develop Gaza. They are getting funds from United Nations. They are getting aid from other countries instead of them using the aid to build their country, to provide social amenities, to provide electricity, water, hospital. They are using the aid they are getting, the money they are getting to build tunnel, to build missile, so they can wipe out the Jews, which I believe is totally wrong. I feel very bad for the people that have lost their loved ones in Israel. I also feel very bad for the people that have lost their loved ones in Gaza, because I believe living in Gaza, living in Israel would be something very miserable. You can imagine waking up every day and living in fears because you don't know the next minute when a missile will be released to where you are. You don't know the next minute where a bomb will be released. I believe those living in Gaza, they live in fear, same as those living in Israel. They are also living in fear because they don't know the next minute Hamas is going to release a missile into Israel. I really wish there is a way all this can be resolved. Maybe a two-state solution whereby they can resolve this problem. Right now, everyone is trying to blame Israel for the problem. They are saying Israel, they are committing genocide. They are killing the people of Gaza, which is not true. And I believe what Israel is trying to do is to eliminate the terrorist group in Gaza, which is Hamas. And Hamas kept on using the civilian as shield. Hamas kept on using the civilian as shield. That's the main problem. And at the end of the day, people will blame Israel that they are killing the civilian. The problem is Hamas. Because from the information I got, I don't know how true this is, that before the people of Israel release any missile into Gaza, release any missile into any building in Gaza, they notify the people of Gaza that this time, this hour, this minute, a missile is going to be released to this location. Civilian, kindly evacuate this area. A missile is going to be released. You can tell for Israel doing this alone, you can tell they want peace. You can tell they are not after the civilian. They are after Hamas, which has been labeled as a terrorist group, because the genesis of all this problem is Hamas. Israel is after Hamas and not after the civilian. But Hamas keep using the civilian as a shield. So, and at the end of the day, the people keep blaming Israel that Israel are killing the civilians, which I believe is not true. I really feel there is a way this conflict between Israel and Gaza can be resolved, maybe with a two-state solution, or if the United Nations can also come in to facilitate this two-state solution, so the conflict between Israel and Gaza can be resolved. And I believe most of this country right now trying to support Palestine, trying to support the Hamas, trying to support Israel, is because they don't know the pain. They don't know the pain the people of Israel are passing through. They don't also know the pain the people of Gaza are passing through. Because, you know, living in Gaza right now is a big problem. You can imagine living in a state, living in a country whereby there's no water, there's no electricity, the infrastructure is very bad, there's no hospital. You can imagine how the situation is going to be. So I really wish the international communities can come in to facilitate a two-state resolution whereby the people of Gaza and the people of Israel can come and decide to, you know, have an agreement to cease fire. I really feel bad. I really feel pain for those that have lost their loved ones. So keep your comments coming. Don't forget, click on the subscribe button, click on the like button. Do have a nice day.